Born and raised in a small town in western Pennsylvania called Washington, PA. It's southwest of Pittsburgh, about 25 miles. I went to parochial high school. They didn't have sports until my sophomore year, and they had basketball, and I never practiced or been much at basketball, so I wasn't really a superstar. I did shoot on a rifle team, but it was a club team throughout my high school years, and I was a Boy Scout. So I really liked Boy Scouts. I made it to the rank of Eagle, and that was a very good background for my military activities.
In 1964, with tensions in Southeast Asia mounting daily, Walter Joe Marm enlisted in the Army rather than face the odds of being drafted as a grunt. After graduating from officer candidate school, the young second lieutenant was assigned to an air mobile unit, a new type of fighting force that would use helicopters to deploy into battle. On November 14, 1965, Marm was leading a rifle platoon through the Ia Drang Valley when he received word that a sister company had been cut off and were under heavy enemy fire. Ordered to relieve the embattled company, Marm and his group were headed into one of the first major battles of the Vietnam War.
My company commander says, attached me to Bravo Company to make an assault to try to get up to them. So I went up and linked up with the Bravo Company commander, and we made an attempt to get up to Bravo Company. We weren't successful, we had to pull back. And so we started up a second time late in the afternoon with an artillery prep in front of us. And we were taking heavy fire from our front, from the NVA. And there was one machine gun, it was an anthill, we call it a machine gun bunker, but it was a solidified rock anthill. It was about 7 or 8 feet in height and maybe about 6 feet in length. And there were shrubs and trees around it. So it was very difficult to get a grenade over it where the enemy was. I tried to get one of my men to throw a grenade from where we're at, because we were pretty much right in front of the bunker, and I thought we were in a pretty strategic position because most of the firing was going on out to the flanks of the bunker. He threw it and it landed, didn't get over, landed in front, made a big boom. I shot a light anti-tank weapon into that bunker to try to silence it. It went off, made a big boom, really picked up the morale, picked up my morale because of the, we thought we knocked it out. We started forward again, and the weapons fire all along our front picked up again. That's when I said, it's time for me to do it myself. So I ran across 40, 50 yards of open terrain and charged the bunker. Had my rifle and my grenades with me. It was a pretty straight shot. I wanted to do it. I told the men to hold their fire, not to shoot me up while I was doing it. I was worried about getting shot by my own men. Ran front to the front of the bunker, threw a grenade over the top. When it went off, I went around to the left side, and there were still some guys that were there shooting, so I finished them off with my M16. When things were pretty silent from my area, I turned sideways and I told our men, let's go, we gotta get up to the platoon that was trapped on the side of the mountain, when I got shot. Went in my left jaw and went out here, and kind of ruined my day. I thought I was, I had to feel my teeth to make sure I still had my teeth, and one of my sergeant that was the medic in Korea came up, and him and a couple of other guys were the first up. They made it up to me okay, and they patched me up, and a couple of my men took me to the back. That was the first day of the battle, and it lasted for two more days.
On December 19th, 1966, 3 years before returning to Vietnam, Marm was presented the Medal of Honor by Secretary of the Army Stanley Reeser in a ceremony at the Pentagon.
It was a very nice ceremony. A young lieutenant, fresh out of Vietnam and fresh out of the mountains of North Georgia, I was kind of in shell shock. Like you can imagine, being around that much brass. It was quite an awesome experience to see that many generals in one place at one time. I was in awe of all of them. Some people say the medal is harder to wear than it is to earn. I've always been very humble and feel that I wear the medal for all those soldiers in the first Cav that were there in that battle and other battles. I'm just the caretaker of the medal for them. There's so many valorous deeds that go on in combat that, that they all can't be recognized. So I'm no braver than, you know, many of my fellow soldiers. I'm just so grateful that they, you know, that they authorized me to wear it for them. And so I feel I have to uphold the medal for them. You have to take care of your fellow soldiers and walk in their shoes too.